On this week's tip video, we want to talk a little bit about trying to better understand waterfowl, particularly on a feed. When we go out scouting in the evenings and we go look for ducks, we're looking for a couple different things. One, we're trying to find a field that they're in. We're trying to figure out how they're acting in that field. Are they aggressively feeding? Are they resting? Looking through the binoculars, looking at the ducks, trying to figure out, are they doing more searching for food or are they actively feeding? Are they trying to get ahead of one another and they're in one big mob, or are they scattered throughout the field in smaller groups and just further apart? So we're also looking for, where are they coming from? Where are they going to? How long are they staying there? How long are they staying in a section of a field before they move to another section? And these can tell you a lot of different things. Over the years, we've had a number of hunts where we've had 20 to 30,000 ducks in the field, and we go back the next day and never fire a shot. At the same time, we've gone where we've had 500 birds in a field and that's our only option. We've gone in there and shot limits. If they're going through a field but they're head down and they're you can see them searching for food, that tells us that food source is almost depleted. If they've got their head down and they're constantly pecking and they're constantly running through that field and jumping over one another to get to that next bunch of food, we know that there's plenty of food in that feed. They're actively feeding. If you watch a field for a couple days and you can watch a group of birds pick out different sections of the field, you can have a pretty good idea coming in there the next morning of where they're going to be. If they're moving, you know, 150, 200 yards at a time across the field throughout a period of 2 or 3 days, then you have a pretty good idea of where to set up the next morning. When we're scouting an evening before and the ducks get up and they're going to head back to the roost, that last spot that they are is typically the place where we want to start in the morning. But if you get out there and you can see that there's no food, that food source is depleted and there's nothing left for them, you have to fan out, go 100 yards each direction and look for fresh food. When they come in there that next morning, they're going to look at your spread, they're going to look at where your blinds are, they're going to see different things you've put out there for them and the presentation you've given them, and they're going to also be looking for food. And they know that that's where they're going to land. So if you're on a place where they were 2 days ago and there's no food, you could still pull them in there, but chances are they're going to be looking for fresh food in that field. If you don't have a food source left there where you're at, it could be a little bit of a battle trying to get them in there. So the next time you're out scouting and hunting, keep these things in mind, and keep in mind that the X yesterday isn't always going to be the X today.